Welcome to Movie Shortens. We are back again to explain to you a 2016 American science fiction action film called The Fifth Wave. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. A teenage girl, Casey Sullivan, runs out of the woods to an abandoned gas station with a gun in her hand. While picking up some necessities, a man calls her for help. After opening the door, she finds a wounded man sitting with his right hand holding a shotgun and his left hand inside his jacket. She accidentally kills the guy when she asks him to move his left hand because she thinks he's hiding a gun under his jacket. But it's actually a cross necklace. She wishes that she could return to the old beautiful days when she was still a normal high school girl who didn't know how to kill people. At a party, she has fun drinking and talking about boys with her friend Liz. On the way out, she meets her crush, Ben, and compliments him on a pink phone case which belongs to his sister. Arriving home, she sings a song for her little brother Sam, and that's the last normal day of her life. The next day, when Casey and her soccer team are practicing, they realize that all of the phone signals are disabled. A strange object moves around Earth and is now over Ohio, US. It's a huge alien spaceship which can be easily seen in the sky. However, there are no messages from them, which are called the Others, within the first 10 days. Most of the inhabitants move out of Ohio to be safe and only few students come to class, and Casey is one of them. On the 11th day, they release the first wave. The electromagnetic pulse disables the electricity power, deactivates all kinds of engines, including planes. She last sees Ben at the school basketball field. Then the second wave suddenly comes when Casey, along with her brother, is getting water at a lake. An earthquake occurs first, then comes a flood. However, they both survive by climbing up a tree. Earthquakes and tsunamis happen everywhere in other countries, which makes many cities and islands disappear. Then the third wave happens. Bird flu is spread across the world via birds. A lot of people are quarantined or die because of being infected. Casey's mom is one of them. Only some people are immune. In the fourth wave, possessed humans kill other ones. Casey, together with her dad and Sam, goes to a summer camp which is used as a refuge in the woods. Just around 300 survivors are living here. Her dad gives her a shotgun and teaches her how to use it. Some days later, a unit of army comes to the camp. The command wants to take all of the children to Wright-Patterson base, then come back to pick up the others because he believes there will be a fifth wave. Her dad has no choice but to be separated from his kids. However, after getting on the bus, Sam insists on going back to the camp to get his stuffed bear. Therefore, Casey has to rush to get it for him, then she realizes the bus is leaving and thought she tries to catch up with it. However, she can't. She looks for her father and witnesses the army shoot all of the adults, including her father. Casey takes a gun and tries to run to the base, but she gets shot on the leg and passes out. At the base, the children are implanted with a tracking device in their neck and are trained to be squads by military detection. They say that humans outside the base are all possessed now, and that they must kill the host in order to kill the parasite in their head controlling them. A week later, Casey wakes up in the house of Evan, the young man who saves her. She pretends to be asleep as she hears someone opening a door, but Evan knows she's already awake. He tries to stop the wound from getting worse and then they have a short conversation. He says he's a normal human being. At the dorm, when Ben's squad is playing a game, a cool tough girl enters and tells Ben, the leader, that she will not follow his orders. She is Ringer, the former leader of another squad. Then she hits a boy in the neck for teasing her and walks away. At Evan's house, while he is chopping wood logs, Casey enters his room and discovers her gun under the floor. Feeling frightened, Casey packs her stuff and runs into the woods. But suddenly, she trips over a string and falls. Luckily, Evan catches her and covers her mouth at the right time while a helicopter is passing by. The other is also hunting near here. When they return home, Casey asks Evan in anger why he hid her gun. Evan tries to explain that he doesn't want the others wandering around to shoot her, so he hides the gun and makes some traps in the woods. Evan claims that Sam is already dead, but Casey couldn't accept it, insisting that her brother is still alive at the base and that she must go there to find him. Evan offers to go with her to the base. They depart in the early morning. In the woods, Evan is teaching Casey to use a gun. At the same time, Ringer is also guiding her team to shoot. Ben, or Zombie, his code name, is called to meet the Colonel. The Colonel says that the others have already started a fifth wave in the last metropolitan area. He showed Ben a helmet, which can help distinguish humans from the others, with an innovative device in front of it. Four squads will be sent to the battlefield tomorrow, and Ben's squad is one of them. The next morning, Casey wakes up without Evan. So she looks for him, then finds him bathing in the river. Suddenly, Evan looks at her, causing her to run back to the tent in embarrassment. After Evan returns, she shows him some photos of her best friend, Liz, her crush, Ben, and her family members. Casey feels shy because Evan has read her journal. They walk along on an old trail until it gets dark. The night before the battle, Sam talks to Ben, asking about their real names. Sam says that his sister often sings for him when he can't sleep. Hearing that, Ben sings for him despite being complained about by other members. Meanwhile, Casey is supposed to change the cotton bandage for her wound when Evan offers to help. Immediately, Casey feels touched and she can't help kissing Evan. They have a great time together in a broken car. In the early morning, when all of the squad's members get on the helicopter and about to depart, Ringer asks about Sam, whose code name is Nugget. Ben lies to her that Sam suffers from food poisoning and can't go with them. Truth is, Sam is tied to the wall in the dorm bathroom by Ben because he is worried about the kids' safety. They are ordered to break into the enemy's nest to find the others and kill them. When the squads discover some of the others, they start to open fire. Some of the members are so scared that they can't even move. They try to run into the bus to hide themselves. Thinking that they've lost Teacup, Oompa stands up to look for her. The moment she says, "I'm here," is also the time when Oompa gets shot and stops breathing. Realizing that they can't stay here anymore, Ben suggests moving to the small alley where they have backups. However, it is a bit far from here and they need a distraction. Ringer volunteers. She tells Ben to cover for her so that she can distract the others. Ben persuades Teacup to follow his order, seeing she's too scared to move. Outside, Ringer puts a grenade into the fuel tank of the bus and asks her squad to run out before it explodes. After that, all succeed in getting into an old building. Ringer suspects that the commander lied to them and that she doesn't want to continue doing this anymore. Right after she takes a tracking device out of her neck, everyone gets shocked since she lights up green in their tracking device. While the others want to shoot her, Ben puts the gun down and starts to take his too. In the others' panic, he turns green too. Realizing the truth of being lied to by the army, Ben persuades everyone that the tracker is just a trick and green means human, and that the others are not the people in front of them but the army. They want to use kids because they think it's easier to train them to kill humans. They realize that the squads are the fifth wave. After asking his teammates to remove the trackers, Ben realizes that he left Sam in the dorm. Despite the other one's prevention, he plans to go back to the base to rescue Sam. Meanwhile, in the woods, Evan wakes up hearing some noise. There are two men trying to attack him while Casey is still inside the car. Then she witnesses Evan fight and kills the two men easily. She panics and threatens Evan to drop his gun. Evan then admits that he's one of the other, but he's also a human being. He's one of the secret agents that the others sent to the Earth some years ago to kill human survivors. Evan admits that it's the love of Casey who makes him want to return to a human being, and it's him who tried to save her when she got shot. Evan tells her that the kids are trained to kill the last human survivors but the army in the base, and she'll be targeted if she goes alone. However, Casey just runs towards the base, leaving him there in the woods. After getting on the helicopter, Ben claims that the other members are dead, and he's the only survivor. Meanwhile, Casey falls in front of a military bus and she's driven to the base. She is then implanted and told the same thing as the other kids by Sergeant Resnick. When being shown the illusion of the others, Casey suddenly turns around and tries to strangle that lady with a computer mouse's wire. Next, Casey removes the implant and changes her clothes with the army uniform of the sergeant. At the same time, Ben is confronting the colonel about the squad's death. He claims that Ben is lying and wants them both to share their secrets. Ben says he knows that the colonel is the other. The colonel admits it. He defends that they just need another space, like the way humans wipe out the entire species. A soldier reports about the death of Sergeant Resnick and three guards in the West Gate. Then an explosion occurs. On the way to be executed, Ben kills the soldier and escapes with his gun. He removes the implant and throws it. When he's running to the departure area to retrieve Sam, he accidentally meets Casey, who is also looking for her brother. They recognize each other and Casey follows him. When they meet two guards who try to stop them from entering, Evan jumps down from the ceiling and knocks them down in a blink of an eye. He says that he's been planting a bomb in the base and it's going to explode in 10 minutes after all of the kids are transported to another base. They then separate. Casey and Ben go to the area where the human children and the military evacuate by military aircraft. They try to find Sam in a crowd and luckily, they found and got him. Casey gives back to him his teddy bear and they run out of the building. When Casey, Sam, and Ben are already outside, they see the colonel. After that, he gets on the helicopter and tries to shoot them from there. Fortunately, they hide behind a truck and don't get shot. The ground starts to crack and the base explodes. The debris flies out everywhere and the ground collapses behind their back. Ringer comes back with a car at the right moment to help them. Holding Sam in her hands, Casey looks back at the explosion and the ruins, then smiles. After arriving at Ben's squad reunion place, they cook some food. Casey looks for some stars in the sky even though it's not yet dark. They all have dinner together. Casey thinks that it's hope that lets them survive and will let them win one day. And it's hope that makes them humans. Subscribe to watch more videos like this and don't forget to turn on your notification. That really helps my channel. Thanks for watching!